Dear brothers, greetings to each one of you from the Marist International Centre in Nairobi. Here in this place, as you probably know, just behind me, we inaugurated a park that was in memory of a brother who was member of your region, Brother Charles Hawa. He, a superior general, was the one behind the idea and the creation of this center of formation for our brothers in Africa. From here, Happy New Year to each one of you. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Dear brothers, I know that you are gathered as Marist of the Oceania region to think, to share, to live fraternally during a few days, reflecting on the future of the Marist life and mission in this part of the world. So my best wishes for your meeting. And also I would like to share with you a couple of ideas reflecting from this part of the world where I am now. I've participated in the provincial chapter of the province of Central East Africa, and some ideas came to my mind as I reflected also on what you are doing now. The first thing is about this powerful concept that many African cultures have, that is Ubuntu. I think it's very challenging for our very individualistic cultures, because, you know, the translation of Ubuntu is more or less as a concept as I am because we are. So it's more important the belonging to the group than my own singular person. And in fact, what gives identity is the group. I am because we are. I think that probably is this universal dream of having a world without boundaries, where we can consider every person as my brother or my sister. So probably for all of you, as you gather as Oceania region, is an invitation to go beyond your own boundaries, your own prejudices, your own preconcepts, all these stereotypes that we have, one about the other. It is, I think, Ubuntu, the power of we. And in our culture, I think is very prophetic. In fact, you know that the recent document of the Vatican on the vocation of the religious brother underlines very clearly that the DNA of our vocation is the fraternity. It seems to me that the call is like to exaggerate the fraternity. And in our individualistic societies, this is a very powerful sign. The Pope, in his apostolic exhortation Evangelii Gaudium, when he talks about the social commitment, talks about four principles. And one of them is that the whole is greater than the part. It is another interesting concept to reflect on as you gather as a region. The whole is greater than the part. And he puts as a model not the sphere, but the polyhedron. Because in the polyhedron, every single part is respected as a different part. So the model is not uniformity, but unity respecting the diversity. Invitation to live Ubuntu, to live as a brothers, and going beyond our own natural boundaries. What I would like to do also, brothers, is an invitation. And my invitation is to dream big. I think it was 2 years ago, a journalist wanted to interview me about Marist vocation, religious life, different concepts. And I remember there was one of the questions about the crisis of vocation in Europe, North America, Australia, New Zealand. And she asked me, what's going on? What happened with this crisis of vocation? So I had to reflect about that. And my answer was, well, I think that God is still calling today, because I really believe that our vocation as Marist brother is still relevant today because of the reality of young people all around the world, doesn't matter which continent. So if God is calling because our way of life is really relevant, it is important, still relevant today, what happens? I think probably two things. One is that God is calling, but young people cannot hear this call. They are so busy, so preoccupied with many things that they cannot hear the call from God. The second thing could be that perhaps they listen to the call of God, but they are not interested about what we are offering to them. In both cases, we can do something on that. We can help young people to hear the voice of God, to make silence, to open a space, to listen the voice of God, to accompany them in their discernment. And also, we can do something on our way of life. If what we are offering is really not relevant for them, they are not interested on what we are offering, we have something to do there. So, brothers, what can we do together, remember, Ubuntu, to revitalize the vocation of the Marist brother in Oceania? What can you do? Perhaps you are feeling weak. And you are saying, well, we are not many, there are problems all around. I remember a few weeks before the general chapter, the last general chapter, I found an article in one of the magazines that we received in Rome, and I was shocked by the title. The title was, "Are you weak enough to become a priest?" Well, I read the article, and only during the general chapter, the celebration of the general chapter, it came again to my mind. Especially when brothers started to talk about the possibility of me becoming superior general. So I remember that I share with the members of the general chapter this same reflection. Are you weak enough to become superior general? Brothers, are you weak enough to allow God to act in your own lives? Sometimes we have to feel weak and we have to have the experience of our own limit and poverty to allow the action of God. Brothers, again, my best wishes for your time together. And my invitation to enter deeply into the reflection, and an invitation to commit yourself. I think this is a wonderful moment. This is a moment of grace in your history. And all of you are invited to go forward. Remember, brother, if not you, who? If not now, when? Thank you.